Hello viewers, so welcome to my channel. I'm Hasham Ali Khan. So now in this video I'm taking up a new topic in business statistics too, that is time series. Already two videos I have uploaded, the first video on regression analysis, second video on index numbers. These short videos I'm preparing for the benefit of students because they are going to appear in few days. They are having the exams, and I already told you in exams almost 40% question paper will be on theory. So don't concentrate only on problems, give more equal weightage to theory also. Compulsory theory question will be asked. So already I have uploaded so many videos on time series for all the problems, on calculating the straight line trend, on seasonal variation, all these things I have already uploaded. So you have to visit the playlist, select the subject business statistics 2, select the topic of time series. You will get all the problems in detail, but this short video I'm making just to brush up the knowledge so that you can be able to write the theory question with confidence. So now time series analysis. See here, we can see in a number of cases the data can be arranged according to time, the variables can be arranged according to time. Simple example I'll give you: a business organization will arrange the data of sales of the last 10 years. The last 10 years data is arranged according to time. For example, the data is given for 2010 to 2019. So from 2010 to 2019, for 10 years, the sales are recorded for every year. For 2010, sales are so and so. For 2011, sales, 2012, 13, 14, 15, like that 2019, up to 2019. The sales are recorded according to time, that is time series. Similarly, another example, apart from sales, a business organization will record the profits for the last 10 years. If you come to, governmental departments, the government will record agriculture production for the last 10 years, industrial production for the last 10 years, taxes collections for the last 10 years, import export for the last 10 years. Example I'm giving. So all these cases, the variables are recorded according to time, and that is called time series. And by analyzing the time series, we can be able to make the planning of the business. So this time series analysis will be very much helpful to a business organization for studying the pattern of change of the variables according to time. So here a time series consists of data arranged chronologically. Chronologically means according to time. Time wise, the data is not mixed up. We are having 10 years sales. We have not mixed up all the sales of 10 years. We have arranged the sales according to year wise. First year sales, second year sales, third year sales, like that. That is called chronological order. So time series consists of data which is arranged chronologically. Then a time series is a set of observations taken at specified times, usually at regular intervals. That means the time period should be regular. First we have taken 2010, then we have taken 2011, 2012. So every year I am recording with regular intervals. I am not making a skipping in between. For example, after 2010 I am taking 2012. After 2012, I am taking 2015. That means it is not a time series. It is not regular. Irregularly, I am recording. So that is not a time series. In time series, the data should be recorded regular period of time for every year. Here, time doesn't mean only year. The time means month. The time means hour. The time means year. So whenever I say time, it relates to either according to years or months or according to weeks or days. So anything can come for time. So recording all the variables according to time is called time series. Thus a time series is a bivariate data. Two variables are there. The first variable is time. The other variable is the other constants. Example, the other constant may be sales, maybe profit, maybe industrial production, maybe agricultural production, maybe export, anything. So these two variables, that's why it is called bivariate data. One variable is always time. One variable is always time. That's all. This is the brief explanation about time series. Now, what do you mean by time analysis of time series? The data given in the time series are not constant. The sales for all the 10 years given are not same. The sales are changing. So we have to study what are the reasons that sales are differing, that sales are changing. So analyzing the data given in the time series, that is called analysis of time series. Why we have to analysis? We want to find out what are the factors that drives to changes in the values for every year. What are the factors which affects the changes in the values every year? That is called analysis of time series. Now, objectives of time series analysis. So why we study this time series analysis? What is the objective? The first objective is to evaluate past performance. See, the past performance is not a guarantee that whatever had happened in the past that will be repeated in the future. There is no guarantee. But still, for making a forecasting about the future, we will make use of the past. We'll make use of the past. So by analyzing the past and making the changes therein, we can be able to make the prediction for the future. We can be able to make the prediction. So until and unless we analyze the past, it will be difficult to estimate about the future. The objective of this time series analysis is to evaluate the past performance. Secondly, to make future forecast. Every management requires to make the planning. The main objective, the main function of management is planning, first function. So for making the plan, the management has to forecast. And making the forecast, time series analysis will be a handy tool in the hands of the management. So this time series analysis will help the management in forecasting the data. Next one is to chart out short-term and long-term strategies for the business. This time series analysis should be helpful to the management for making different types of plans, short-term plans and long-term plans. The simple words, by using this time series analysis, the management can be able to make the planning, short-term planning, long-term. These are the objectives. Next comes utility of time series. What is the benefit from time series? Why we study this subject or topic of time series? How it will be helpful to the management? Definitely it is helpful. Otherwise it would not have been included in the syllabus. It will not be used. Many benefits are there. What are the utilities of time series? The first is helps in understanding the past behavior of the variable. It helps. This time series will help the management in evaluating the past performance. Example, the company. Currently the company, we are in 2021. Now the company wants to evaluate the past performance in the last 5-10 years, how the company have performed, how much are the sales, how much are the profits, how much are the investments. All these things in the last 10 years, in 5 years. So understanding, evaluating the past performance, that is the utility, first benefit. Then second one, helps in planning future operations. By undertaking this time series analysis, we can be able to plan for the future. Without planning, actually no business can run. Every businessman has to make the planning about the future. And this time series analysis will be helpful in making the future plans. Next, helps in evaluation of current operations. Not only deciding about the future, but also current operations can be evaluated. We can be able to control the business because we have already used the time series analysis and we can compare that whatever we have planned, are we achieving it or not? Current accomplishment is according to our plans or not? That means this time series will not only help in planning, but also it will help in controlling the activities. Next one, helps in forecasting the behavior of phenomena in the future. Understanding the behavior, how it will behave in the future, how the variables are going to behave in the future. Last one, it helps in isolation of the impact of various factors affecting time series. In the time series, a number of factors are there which affect the changes in the values. So isolating all the factors. Example, the sales of 2010 are 100. For 2011, it is 120. For 2012, it is 130. So why these sales are changing from 100 to 120, 120 to 130? Some factors may be there. On account of those factors, the values are changing. So business can be able to isolate, find out what are the factors which makes these values are changing from 1 year to another year. So these are the utility benefits of using time series in an organization. So now, components of time series. See here, the data given in the time series are changing. Now the question arises, what are the factors that makes the values changes? Many factors are there, innumerable factors are there which affects. For example, the factors are affected, the variables are changing on account of income of the people. Example, the sales of automobile. A company, automobile company is there. The sales of automobile company shows increasing trend. Now the question arises, what are the factors which makes changes in the increase in sales? There are innumerable factors are there. The first factor may be the income of the people might have increased. Second factor may be population have grown up. Thirdly, the people's tastes and habits have changed. Fourthly, the cost of production might have come down. That's why prices have decreased. So many, even government policies are there. On account of all these factors, the values are changing from year to year. So the factors are classified into components. So in order to study the changes in the variables, we divide the factors into components. So there are four components of time series. The four components are secular trend, seasonal variations, cyclical variations, and random or irregular variations. These four are called components of time series. In examination, very frequently it will be asked, explain the components of time series. So remember this. Remember these four. The first one is secular trend. The secular trend shows the long-term tendency of the value either to increase or to decrease or to remain constant or to fluctuate. So in a long period of time, the values, what is the behavior of the value? What is the behavior of the value in the long period of time? Whether the values are continuously increasing or the values are declining or the values are remaining constant or the values are fluctuating. The long-term tendency of the variable, how it is behaving, that is called secular trend. Example, if you see the passengers of airlines, in the last 10 years, the passengers using airlines, airways passengers are increasing. So every year you can see the number of passengers going through airlines are increasing every year. So it shows an increasing trend. So if we analyze the time series of passengers availing airlines, you can see upward trend increasing. Whereas infant death, if you see the last 10 years, infancy death at the time of birth at the time, and child mortality rate is declining. Why it is declining? So many reasons are there. There is technological development in medical field. In medical field, a lot of technological development are taking place. New medicines are coming. New facilities are coming up. So on account of all these things, infant mortality rate is coming down every year. This is the tendency that the rate of infant mortality is decreasing. The number of passengers are increasing. The number of students taking the admission in graduation level increasing. So by seeing this, we can say the long-term tendency of the variable either to increase or decrease is called secular trend. Secular trend is the basic tendency to a series to grow, decline, remain constant or fluctuate. The long-term trend helps in determining the direction. Why we study trend? To find out the direction, whether it is increasing or declining. Now, characteristics of trend. The first characteristic, long period of time. Trend will not be calculated only for 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. If you want to find out the trend, take a long period of time. Like for example, 10 years, 15 years, if you analyze, If you analyze the time series for 10, 15 years, then only you can be able to judge the long-term direction of change. Long-term direction. Next one is trend upward, downward or stable. When you analyze the trend, some cases, some variables will show increasing trend, some variables will show declining trend, some variables are constant for a long period of time, and some variables will fluctuate every year. So, these are the possibilities in long-term trend. Then, impact of stable factors. The factors which affect this long-term trend are normally stable. It will not be random. It will be stable. Next, trend may be linear or non-linear. Linear means there is proportionate change from one year to another year. If the change in the variable is proportionate every year, then we can say linear trend. Example, the sales are increasing by 10% every year. Linear trend. The sales are increasing at a different rates. In one year 10%, another year 20%, next year 15%. There is disproportionate change in the variable. It is called non-linear trend. So these are the characteristics, features of trend. The first component I have explained you. In examination, you may get a theory question regarding explain the secular trend. So whatever I have explained, that will be more than enough to write. Next is seasonal variations. The changes in the values of time series may be on account of seasonal variations. Seasonal variations are the fluctuations or change in the value within a period of 1 year. And it is repetitive. That means changes are occurring in a repeated manner every year, predictable. So here, seasonal variation involves pattern of change within a year. That tend to get repeated year after year. The changes will get repeated every year. So within the 12 months period, you can find the changes. Again, the same changes you can find in the next year. Again, the same changes you can find in the again next year. The same, changes will occur within a period of 1 year, and it is repetitive every year you will get. The trend is repetitive and fluctuating at its peak and bottom about the same time of the year. The fluctuation will reach the peak and bottom, up and down within a year. And this pattern will be repeated every year. Will be repeated every year. Simple example I'll give you. In case of sale of umbrellas. The sale of umbrellas, raincoat will be more during monsoon season. So as soon as the monsoon comes, normally in India we will have the monsoon in the month of June, July, August. So during the month of June, July, August, the sale of umbrellas, the sale of raincoats will increase. As soon as the June, July, August over, September, October comes, then monsoon is over. Now slowly the demand for umbrellas and raincoats will come down. And this pattern will be there every year, not in 1 year, every year. So it is repetitive. This changes which is occurring within 1 year and repetitive is called seasonal variation. Now, characteristic of seasonal variation, first one, repeats themselves periodically within 1 year. These changes, that means going up to peak and coming to bottom, then going up to peak, coming bottom. So these changes will occur every year, repeated. Secondly, factors that are uniformly and regularly rise and fall in the same manner. That means the factors which are affecting this up and down, these factors will be same every year. That means the monsoon, during monsoon, the sale of umbrellas increases because during monsoon, there will be rain, people require umbrella. The factors are same. Second factor. Then third characteristic feature is they can be predicted without much difficulty. This seasonal variation can be predicted. Easily we can predict that in this month the demand is going to be more, in this month the demand is going to be less. Example, soft drinks. Another example, the demand for soft drinks will increase during summer season. The people will use more soft drinks, the demand will be more. As soon as the summer is over, winter comes, the demand for soft drinks will decrease. The business can be able to make the planning. So before summer comes, everything will be get ready for making more production of soft drinks. The planning will become easier. Next, causes of seasonal variation. Why these seasonal variations will occur? Why? There are two reasons. First one is on account of natural forces. Second, on account of man-made conventions. Natural forces means just like rainfall, monsoon. Monsoon will occur every year naturally in the month of May, or in the month of June, July, August. That is by nature. We cannot change it. So these factors, these seasonal variations are occurring on account of natural factors which cannot be changed. Secondly, on account of man-made conventions. There are some rules which are made by man on account of that these seasonal variations are occurring. Example, during festival season. So whenever festival comes, the demand for goods will increase. Festival is over, the demand comes down. These festivals are not natural, it is man-made. So we have decided when this festival will come. So this seasonal variation may occur on account of man-made factors or on account of natural factors. Utility of seasonal variation. Why seasonal variation? We have to study. A business has to conduct the study of time series or seasonal variations. What are the reasons? First one, formulating policy decisions. The study of seasonal variation will be very much helpful to the management for making policies, for making the planning. Just now I've given the example. Before summer season comes, the soft drink company will make a lot of plans that our production will increase. We have to collect we have to organize the resources. We have to make the planning for production. We have to make the planning for distribution. So we have to gear up the planning before the summer comes. So secondly, planning day-to-day operations. So by having the study of this seasonal variation, we can make day-to-day planning also. Thirdly, diversification strategy. See here, when there is no demand, the company will not be wound up. We have to make the diversified activities. Example, a company which is making soft drinks. The demand for soft drinks will be more during summer. But as soon as the summer is over, the company will not be shut down. The company has to make diversified strategies. So during non-summer season, the company may make some other products, some other goods, so that the company can be able to survive. So diversification strategies we can make. Next one, project past patterns into future. By studying the past pattern of seasonal variations, we can be able to make the planning for the future. Then last one, proper appraisal of business facts. By having this seasonal variation, the company can be able to appraise the business strategies. So these are the utility of studying seasonal variation. The two components I have explained you. First one, secular trend. Second one, seasonal variation. Secular trend is the long-term tendency of the variable either to increase or decrease or fluctuate or constant. Whereas in case of seasonal variation, these are the variations within a period of 1 year. And it is repetitive. The same pattern will be followed every year. That is called seasonal. Next one is cyclical variations. The cyclical variation is a series. In a series are the recurrent variations whose duration is more than 1 year. In seasonal variations, the variations are occurring within 1 year. The variations are repeating within 1 year. It is called seasonal. If the variations are repeating not in 1 year but more than 1 year, that means the variations are occurring not within 1 year but in 5 years, in 10 years, like that. That is called cyclical variation. So cyclical variations are regular but not periodic. Periodic means it is not occurring every year. It is relatively more difficult to predict. Seasonal variations easily we can predict, but this cyclical variation we cannot predict easily. A cycle lasts for 7 to 9 years. One cycle will take approximately from 7 to 9 years. After 7 to 9 years, again second cycle will come. After 7 to 9 years, again next cycle will come. So it will rotate every 7 to 9 years. The most common example of cyclic variation is business cycle. So every economy will pass through business cycle. The business cycle is completely a cycle which passes through different stages. The stage are boom period, now recession period, depression period, recovery period. So these are the four phases of one business cycle. Boom period, recession period, depression period and then recovery period. The one cycle will be covered approximately around 10 years. So 10 years are required to complete one cycle of the four stages. So this 10 years period completes one cycle. After one cycle, next cycle will begin again for a period of 10 years. So these are called cyclical variations. And it is difficult to predict the cyclical variations because the duration of time is more, 10 years. Now, last variation, last component of time series is random or irregular variations. Random or irregular variations. So in many situations, the value of a variable may completely be unpredictable and completely changing in a random manner. In many cases, if you analyze the time series, we can see the values are randomly changing, unpredictably changing, because some factors will arise unpredictable. Some changes may occur. For example, all of a sudden there was a flood, there was a drought. So these things are completely unpredictable. We cannot predict it. So there are some changes in the time series on account of erratic factors, on account of unpredictable factors. They are called random factors. Random factors. A simple example, this pandemic has come. Have you predicted some 5 years back, 10 years back, that during the year 2019, 2020, some pandemic will come, some lockdown will come? No, we have not at all predicted. We have never thought of this pandemic or lockdown like that. So this is unpredictable. This factor is unpredictable. So due to this pandemic, lot of effect will be there on the economy. The production, the sales, everything has been affected on account of this pandemic. So it's an example of unpredictable, random change. These fluctuations are a result of several unforeseen and unpredictable forces that operate in absolutely erratic and irregular manner. Whereas this seasonal variation, cyclical variation, there is a predictable changes. These are the predictable changes. But these are completely unpredictable changes, irregular changes. There is no definite pattern and there is no regular period of time of the occurrence. It will not follow any particular pattern, particular path. Randomly changes may occur. So these are called random or irregular variations. So in this video, I have explained you the meaning of the term time series, the analysis of time series, what are the objectives of the study of time series, what is the utility of time series, and lastly, what are the components of time series. The components of time series are secular trend, seasonal variation, cyclical variation, and random or irregular variation. So in examination, theory will be asked on these components, or what is time series, what is the utility of time series. So after watching, after listening this video, definitely I hope student can be able to understand this topic and they can be able to write in examination confidently. So if you are satisfied with my lecture, give a like to the video. Share my channel in your group, in your friend circle, so that more students can watch the video and enhance the knowledge. Give your comments. And lastly, don't forget to subscribe my channel. Inshallah, I'll continue the next topic in the next video.